All right, we're okay. Welcome to welcome to Der Shrine looks at the Type 59 Legend. I'm Der Shrine, and we are in part two, so let's continue. And today we're in this video we're going to be doing the combat, which I probably put annotations in the last video saying this is just me talking or putting a description somewhere. I'll probably put a description that's more reliable for me. Do you remember putting annotations? Because I prefer, you know, when I upload something, I prefer tapping in everything before it's uploads. I mean, while it's uploading. And then just, you know, get everything sorted when it's uploading. That's it. So, yeah, that's all the people online, but we're going to find a match because everyone's playing their Type 59s. But, yeah, like I said in the first part, I do like Type 59. I mean, I already played a match, and I'll link in the description to my gameplay video where I did play a match, in case you want to see my first match in Type 59. And, yeah, it's... Well, we'll see. I will spoil it for you guys if you guys didn't watch that video. Got to remember not to read the text. I don't need to read the text. Alright, so this is a fair match. Actually, is this a good match? Oh, this is a really good match. Because we're not fighting anything we can't penetrate. But not like that's a problem for us, but still. I guess T-62s could be a problem. But the rest we can easily deal with, and they can't really easily deal with us. Although there's a titter I gotta worry about, but me worry about a titter since when? And Atari's never been a problem for me in this game and in Wolf Tanks. Mainly because they always miss. Sure, they miss me hit my teammate, one-shot my teammate, but I rarely get one-shot by Atari. The only time I ever get one-shot by Atari in Wolf Tanks is simple. I'm in a T2 light, going across the field, and I get one-shot by Atari out of nowhere. That's the one time I ever get one-shot by Atari in a fast tank going across the field. Being a nice, fat, heavy tank and just sitting in a camping spot, I never get killed by artillery. I will get damaged, and the only way they can kill me is by, well, shooting me 5,000 times until the ping away enough my health. And this is a Type 59. Let's get moving. Let's see our acceleration. Because we're going downhill, but oh well. Right, where should we head? I probably should be going to town, but. Actually, yeah, they can cover that. I ain't get town. I hope those three can cover it. Can cover the road of regret. But, yeah, I mean, the thing about the Type 59 is it's not slow. It's not slow in any means. Oh, hello, APC. I mean, hello, AMX. Oh, we got an X-800 getting engaged by... Oh, he's kind of suicide going up. You know, I hope he's not trying himself killed. Oh, you know what? We gotta get down there. I never go this way, but it looks like it's gonna. They're gonna need assistance. And since we have the armor, we can take these guys on. You saw how good you saw in like the last part. If you watched the last part, how good this armor is. Of course, it's not as good as the Pan's armor, but then again, this thing actually has side armor, which you still don't get in shot in the side, by the way. There you go, Type 54. A T-54 on that side. Alright, we're gonna stay right here. Yeah, they're gonna be coming this way. Oh, actually, they're gonna... Ooh, I think we move... Oh, can we snipe this guy? Across the map? Remember, I don't know if they're good side armor. Oh, X-800. And wait for it. Fire. That didn't work as planned. I was going to shoot through that, but oh well. But they know we're here now, that's for certain. I want to get shot on that guy because the scouts are annoying sometimes. We gotta be careful. Remember, like I said, we don't have that much side armor. We gotta be careful. We gotta be very careful. And if we see Sheridan, run away, because Sheridan's our problems for us. Okay, we're getting backed up by an LAV. Good to know. Yeah, there's just so much terrain between us and them, we can get a clear shot. Okay, maybe we should have our guys top side. Because our people have the people in the middle locked down, so we can retreat. We can reposition. We just want to go that way. Yeah, let's go this way. Hopefully I don't get spotted. That'd be bad getting shot on the side from over here. We have a lot of health! But we don't want to waste it. I guess we have moderate amounts of health. Got no biz on those guys. Or got no line of sight on those guys. You know, we can go over here. Trying to run over anything. Well, at least it didn't explode. If they explode, that's bad. And they should have been over it to begin with. Lock that turret. Alright, you are. Oh no. Oh, that's a worker bulldog. Yeah, he can't penetrate me, but I can sure as anything penetrate that guy. But they know we're here now, so we're no longer on the stealth mission. You're in position to sneak up behind these fools. Gotta worry about everything. You got visual on that guy? Or Ellis? And the mark thing always gets me. I always think it's my people spying something, but it never is. And well, the worker bulldog decided to run away. Oh, affirmative. In my asterisk. Where is that worker bulldog? Got to be. We must be vigilant! The enemy could be anywhere! I could be going after artillery, though. I'm thinking that they're coming this way. Not as inclined by what I'm doing, but I'm not quite sure. They could be going after artillery. Oh, get wrecked. Let's keep moving. The LAV is not finding anything. Yeah, I figured. Let's use our speed to our advantage. That's how fast this thing goes on a road. That LAV can get there and wreck them. Affirmative. And I know they have main battles. Stay on the road and go. Stay on the road and go. Oh, they're crossing the bridge. Okay, people that are in road are flying back to help the titteries. Alright. Well, at least we gotta see this thing's movement and stealth abilities. In case we don't get to shoot them. Came that low. It's my only chance. Okay, those guys are getting up. Okay, T-59. Now we got an AMX spotting, that's good enough. Okay, that guy's dead. That guy's dead. He's gone. Alright, so they got three guys on Road of Regret. At maybe. They have one guy in their base. Where could they be? Yeah, let's link up with this AMX. See if he found anything. Things are exploding. Wait a sec. Oh, that's him, alright. No, I guess we gotta shoot the armor as well, because it actually bounced a Walker Bulldog shot. There is that guy, but our team has it covered. Let's see if Harkin. I mean, the Scorpion, the Scorpion should be no problem for us. Except if he gets around us and shoots us in the rear, then it might penetrate us, but I don't think he will. If we blunt smart, if we just don't rush in there and yeah, I like there. You know where we are. Being backed up by T-54. Oh, is he stuck? Fire. Oh, he is already damaged. All right. That was a close. That could have been bad. Oh, it was kind of close. Alrighty. Okay, that match we showed off our immobility, we basically showed off all the aspects of the tank in that match. And with that match, without premium, we got 2,098 experience and 47,981 credits. And emergency contributions were 864 spot damage, 3 spots, and 227 damage. Never done a team, but we couldn't find anyone basically. And the one guys we did find was AFK, and Sabrina, I can upgrade you. Oh, sure. Alright, that should help. Alright, so now let's do another match and just continue seeing how this thing goes. Now my first match, I did bounce a whole lot of things. Basically, I bounced everyone else's guns. From M60s, from upper ones, I think, from for sure, C64s, and even LAV300s. I bounced everything off this tank. As we saw with the Walker Bulldog, he just bounced off us. Sure, that was a really oblique angle, but still, he bounced off our front, no problem. If I was in a Leopard 1, that would have went clean through. Maybe it would have bounced because of the angle, but I'm pretty sure it wouldn't have. If I was in a T-62, would that bounce? Probably. It probably would have bounced. If I was in the pan, it probably would have bounced. Like, that match showed its mobility, its spot range, and its mobility, spot range, and armor. I didn't really show it with a gun. I mean, show the gun a little bit at the end, but that's about it. Come on. But yeah, I really like this thing so far. You know, it's my favorite of the T-Series. If you can call it T-Series. I mean, you can call it T-Series for sure. And by T-Series, I mean T-54 up to T, well, up to T-80s. And T, up to the T-90s, what is, they're all part of the T-Series. Or at least, that's what I call that series. I'm not quite sure what they're officially called. I guess it could just be the Wishing Belting series, but I call them the T-Series. Alright, another tier 4 match. Another really good matchup for us. Of course, we're fighting other T-59s, we're fighting T-62s, we're fighting the Object 430, fighting M-60s. Oh, this could be a bad one. Oh, we're gonna find out. Yes, I'm looking for something. All right, but okay, yeah, we're going to see more artillery. All right, that's good. That artillery in my first match, and we're doing okay. Okay, this map could go any way. Depends on where we go. It could be a close quarter slugfest, which this thing would dominate in, because I mean, look at it. Look at its weak points. From the front. SS, 2 commander satches, but that's about it. I mean, sure it doesn't have all that much hull armor. Eventually the turret, but it's still really good. Now this thing's a bunk. Okay, got people going up already. Got it. I mean, what I noticed on people love to on this map go wherever they spawn, go directly for wherever they spawn. Which is not a bad idea, but I prefer the old beta style, the old beta and alpha style of going either up or down, or either up or through the refinery. And everyone make a going turn here, and we'll turn back for a road. Thank you very much. Sure, this thing's turning. Oh my, where this thing turns up from? Don't run into the object 155. That'd be bad. Oh, Alright, unlike the turret we're going in. Alright, we have. Okay, a scorpion has been spotted and maybe engaging. Oh my, where are they all here? Like I was saying, he's engaging the X-1800. Oh, object 430. Okay, let's keep moving. Oh, great. And remember, as long as they don't shoot down our barrel or hit our commander statues, we're fine. For the most part. Yeah, they were spotted. Identify. Oh, is this guy coming out to play? Kinda is. Oh, there's this track. Oh my word, they're all here. Oh my word, they're all here. Well, we're in a pretty good spot. Terrain! You don't have to be bigger than you actually are, terrain. You don't have to look that fat, come on. Come on, terrain, you don't have to have that much muscular awesomeness. Oh, we can penetrate each other's lower glacises, that's good to know. I mean, yeah, you can also penetrate the lower glacises if you want, I guess. Oh, he's saying, oh, Gunner, you just had to shoot underneath this tank, didn't ya? You should have to shoot underneath this tank. Despite how low this thing is to the ground, he had to shoot underneath this tank. It was a good shot, but you just had to, didn't ya? Oh, yeah, he knows. I'm trying to make that even harder angle, but I'm tricking you away with it. So I guess cover up your hull, and he'll go hold down, and you're pretty much invincible. Okay, this guy. I should be able to shoot through the cover. Don't worry, that round would probably have been underneath him. Anyone else wants to try on me? Oh no, you lied to me. Okay, we're showing our sides in that situation. Oh, we're being shot by, now again. At which we cannot see. I saw you do that. Don't think I didn't. I'm just not going to take a shot. Let's see if we can we're going to see if we can take out their friends. Oh no, let's take out you. Ew. Yeah. Oh, fire. Gotcha. Reload. I just love this thing for this reason, guys. You see how awesome this thing is. Sure, you can penetrate its little glacis, but have that coverage, you're pretty awesome. There's nothing else you can do with the tank. Sure, you can shoot down the barrel, which is my favorite tactic. Maybe you can penetrate. No, and like, you either got the commander's hatches. Oh, you're not doing that. You are not showing your side like that. I mean, I'm showing my lower glacis, but still. I guess we can do extreme angling. He's gone, but we got support. Directly in front of me. I thought it was covered. He's last man standing. Rush him! Remember, when we're in this face, we can penetrate his turret, don't think he can penetrate ours. I'm going for it. There we go. And my friends, was a good match in Type 59. We're going to see in the post-game things how well we did. GG. Yeah, let's be a good sport. Or some people might think we're a complete jerk, but nah, that happens. Alright, yeah, 10 minutes. Let's do one more match. I mean, I just love the Type 59. It's just a very good combination for me. It's my ability, armor, and a gun. What more do you want? And health. Alright, so we got 829 experience. Without a premium. We got 46,853 credits without premium. We did 851 damage, 6 spotting and 2 assists. And we got mid place on our team, alright. Actually, if you look at damage, so we got mid place on the team. That's a good place. Mid place the team with our experience, but with, you know, we did 851 damage, and we got 46,853 credits. That's pretty good. I mean, it's a tier 3, which in armored warfare is a mere tier premium. Basically, tier 3 in this game is like a tier 5 or 4, or maybe, yeah, tier 5, 4, and, tier 5, 4, maybe 6, and World of Tanks, because now there's 9 tiers. As you can see, there are 9 tiers now, but still, but basically the premium system was basically based around the 7 tier system. They do own punning, Ascendant is planning on adding basically a tank for every tier, including tier 10s and tier 9s. But when the premium system was put in place, it was all basically based around the tier 7s. So yeah, that system still stays alive right now. I mean, the tier 3s play like tier 5, or pay out like tier 5s, so, like tier 5s or 4s and Wolf Tanks. While the tier 6s play, tier 6s are like tier 8s in Wolf Tanks. Tier 4s are more like tier 7. I mean, I guess tier 4s are more like tier 7s than 6s. So yeah. Yeah, but overall, I do love this thing. I mean, will I get one in Wolf Tanks if they ever put it on sale, both on PC or an Xbox? I mean, there's a high likelihood of them putting it on sale or making a price for something you can easily attain on Xbox, because they haven't had the Type 59 yet. They went straight to the Chinese tech tree. Or no, they went straight to the Chinese premiums. I guess on the Chinese tech tree as well. So will I get one there? I probably would after playing this thing, because this thing was fun. I might get one if it's reasonably priced, if it's in between $20 and $70, I'll probably get one. Because for a tier 8, for a very good tier 8, $50 is not that bad. I mean, for medium, it should be more around $20-$30, but Wargaming's Wargaming. They don't have the same low pricing as Obsidian does at my.com. Which is, I really appreciate my.com and Obsidian for having much lower pricing than Wolf Tanks does for its stuff. You can get roughly like 2 times more things for the same price. In armored warfare than you can in Wolf Tanks. This is a situation. I guess everyone wanted to play their Type 59s today. Which would make sense. I mean, again, like I said in part one, people love this thing in Wolf Tanks, and most people want one. So yeah. So I gotta say. I'm reading the chat, sorry. People want one in Wolf Tanks, so you can get a free one. From World Warfare, why not do it? Same logic as Sim 60. Because Sim 60 is extremely rare in Wolf Tanks, because it's... Where do we want to go? Okay, fine, let's go up here. Worst case scenario, we gotta fight a scorpion. I'm making sure we don't get flanked. Oh my word, look at our team. I hope they all go that way. It'd be an awesome fight and they can just sneak around the side. There's the first Typhoon now. We're moving fast. Alright. Oh, that's the wall. It means baby Nia. Ooh, nobody alerts if we just go craft our base. Let's see if they all went that way. Oh, this thing really slowed down in the water. Okay, sure, take a whole lot. He took a sweet time slowing down, but it's still dead. Oh my word, there they all are. Ah, looks like someone else decided to come this way. However, oh great. Oh, there's a dumb scorpion. Get off this ridge. Remember, I will be able to shoot his lower glaciers much faster than he can shoot mine. So I do have the advantage in this situation. However, he can shoot down my top. Oh, do we get artillery? We don't. Who's shooting him then? Oh my word, we gotta get moving. They want me dead! They're shooting that guy. I'm gonna come over the hill. I'm gonna shot in the little glaciers. Okay, he fired. That means this guy can't fire. Oh, this guy's a smart one. That's a smart cookie. We got a smart cookie there. And this is what happens when your armor fails. Is this happens? You just get shot from all over. Oh, turn. I took the lesser evil. Of course, you had to shoot in no effect area. Yeah, that better do something. I needed that, you jerk! And they can shoot my tops now. Oh, and they're close enough to me. Did they get my friend? Not yet. I found the L. Oh, hold down location! Ah. Ah, I was gonna shoot his other side. That could've gone better. That is why I went that way, to alert my team of any enemy presence. I was in a bad spot, though. But yeah, I mean, that was a good spot. I just couldn't get, I couldn't get my position so my gun could go down. I mean, as you saw, we ran into a problem of, I mean, that situation is we ran into the gun depression problem. I guess this gun doesn't depress all that well. I don't think it's just fine, but depressing, it's depressing. It depresses me with its depressing inadequacies. We are almost out of time, actually. I'll say that we had some good games. I mean, enough to talk about the Top 99, which I'll be right back once it, I'll be right back once it's, out of battle. So I'll be right back. Alright, oh, we won that one, alright. Okay, in a bad match, we still got, a match we didn't do well, because that was not bad. That wasn't really a bad match. I had fun in that match. We had fun seeing all the Type 59s fighting each other. And even going on a little stealth mission just to get owned, because we just couldn't pack away fast enough. What would have happened in that match if we had went down the hill and went into the water is it would have been able to shoot our tops, and the water would have slowed us down, so we basically had to stand and fight right there. Although, why should I? I shouldn't have ran up and tried to shoot that guy. Be the hero, I should stay back and just shot him when they came over the hill. That's what I should have done, but anyway. We still got 33,668 credits, even with 4 spots, 2 assists, and 234 damage. Off the one more team, at least. Alright, so now let's discuss, what are my thoughts on the Type 59? Is it worth logging in for? Yes, it is. It's very much worth logging in for. This thing's amazing. Maybe this thing has one big weak point that I didn't really see earlier, which is the lure glaciers is a big weak point, but basically if you cover that, then you're looking at that. Ignore that, you're just looking at that and try penetrating that. Sure, you got that big thing to shoot down, but other than that, you gotta shoot the little cupola, or a little, I guess that's a cupola, I mean, they're more like hatches, but yeah, you can shoot those. Who actually catches the turret ring all that well? Like, unlike the other T-Series things, which are the turret rings are weak point. I've admit, not that I've ever been able to figure that one out, but I hear that weak points. But basically, if you cover your Lord Glacius, you're pretty invincible. Which I wanted to take advantage of last battle, but I just got in the position way too late. And my gunner decided to miss. Did he miss or did I not take the shot out? Whatever. But anyway, so yeah, this thing just has really good ability. It has a good gun. It has a good gun. It does have a great gun. Does have a terrible gun. It has a good gun. It has very good reload. It has very, very good armor. Like, the only vehicle that out-armors this thing for its tier is the M60. The M60 just has more armor in the front. However, the Type-59 has more armor all around, which is a good thing. Basically, the M60 is more brawling, more sit in the spot and just shoot things. Basically going in and out of corner shooting things. However, the Type-59 can do that, yes. But it can also go around things pretty easily and get shot up while it does that. Well, the M60 can do that, and you probably should do that in the M60. However, the M60 doesn't have any armor. It doesn't have much armor in the sides and rear, so you can't get away with it as much as you can with the Type-59. So yeah, definitely, I recommend because remember, Armored Warfare is free now. All you gotta do is just download the Mighty.com launcher, download Armored Warfare onto the launcher, and you have Armored Warfare. And all you gotta do is create an account and log in, and then once you see this screen right here, you get your tank. All you gotta do is look around in your garage for it. So yeah, I mean, it's a very, very good tank. Now, what upgrades would I give for it? Now, it being a new premium tank, they actually give you all the upgrades. So what do I give this thing? Actually, I don't know what I would give this thing. It doesn't really need anything. I guess accuracy on the move can't be that bad. And, I guess more accuracy would be nice. More accuracy would be nice, because it doesn't have that much accuracy. And then, no, rapid reload's always fine, and explosive shells can never... Oh, no, explosive shells, reverberation also never could hurt. I suppose bug drill damage can be fun. But yeah, I mean, it just doesn't really need anything. I mean, you can still retrofit it, you can still put consumables on it, you can still, upgrade your people, but it doesn't really need it on, like, some other tanks do. And it's just a very, very good tank. It's as fun as it is on, wall tanks. I don't know, because I haven't got the Type-59 pen, the Type-59 pen, by the way, is this body, and, give me a second, that body, and that head, or that turret, and that's the Type-59 pen. Which is actually a good thing, because you get the best of both worlds. You get the body of a Type-59 and the turret of a M60, which are great things in World of Tanks. So yeah, you get the benefits of both, which is, that's an interesting vehicle. I'm glad that I got it on World of Tanks, which I do have a DLA of it, in case you're interested. But yeah, I mean, I guess, now that I've played Type-59 in Armored Warfare, I kind of want one in World of Tanks. You may be wondering why. Well, the reason why you might want a tank that's in both games, like Type-59 or maybe Type-59, 48 Pen, Walker Bulldog, is because both games are very different. Both tanks and Armored Warfare are very different games. Yes, they're both tank games, but they play differently. Not only does Armored Warfare just have variety in vehicle types, unlike World of Tanks, which has variety in tanks, which is not a bad thing anyway. And also Armored Warfare, I mean, like, the main difference between why you should get a M48 pen in World of Tanks, which is a tier 10, which is a big round to get to, and in this game, it's a tier 2. It's because both games are very different in how they set up the maps. In Armored Warfare, the maps are very cluttered. They're very cluttered maps. And also the very linear type. Unlike World of Tanks, where you got lots of room to run around, in Armored Warfare, you don't really have that. Basically, Armored Warfare is a big slugfest everywhere. Which makes the Leopard 1 not that good, but yeah. But enough of that. I'll save that for a gameplay video later on. But yeah, I mean, my verdict is it's a very good tank, and you should get yourself one. If you're watching this in the future and this tank goes on for sale instead of just simply logging in to get one, Would I recommend it? I would recommend it. Yes, it is a very good tank. Or if it's in the tech trade, the non-premium, I would also recommend it for that as well. Because it might do that, I'm not quite sure. I mean, as a tech tree non-premium tank, it probably doesn't have the emblem, probably doesn't have this custom camouflage. But it will still be a good tank, and, you know, I mean, same goes with the Object 430, which is on sale right now as an ice tank. And I will say this is worth getting an ice tank. And I will say, if this comes for sale in the future, or if you have another event where you log in and get Type 59, I would definitely recommend doing it. I would definitely recommend doing it. It's a very, very good tank. Also, of course, they change it in that time, but I'm pretty sure. They just upgraded things. They haven't really messed with things to make things much worse than what they previously were. Similar to when Wolf Tank swapped into the Super Pershing. That signs me to this day. Not that I ever played Super Pershing before they patched it, and I ever played Super Pershing on PC, never mind. I only played it on Xbox, but still, you know, nerfing a tank into oblivion is not a good idea. And so far, Armored Warfare hasn't done that. If they ever nerfed anything, they just marginally took away took away his powers. They never really just made the thing just not as good. So even if that happens, it's still good, because it'd probably still be a fun tank, just probably not as armored. But I'm pretty sure it's gonna stay where it stayed the same. And I might do another DLA, or I'll definitely be doing more gameplay videos of this tank, because I do love it. It's just a really, really good tank. Alright, so, I definitely recommend it now, because it's a free tank. All you gotta do is log in. I recommend it in the future if it gets paid again, or if it gets put up for sale, at any capacity, whether it be a reskin tank, or it comes back and it's... It comes back in the Type 59 Legend variety, then I would recommend it. I mean, I think the reason why I think it's going to be in the tech tree, because it says Legend here. Like, this says Veteran. So yeah, this might be in the tech tree, and if it is in the tech tree, I definitely would recommend upgrading to it. Alright, but anyway, so that'll be it for this video. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate you watching this video. It means a lot to me. Or these two videos, by the way. These two parts. It means a lot to me. Also, it means a lot to me to leave a comment to watch me. It's going to be very interesting series of what things you want me to do next, or any tips on how I'll use the Type 59 Legend in general, even an old dip Steven's comments for people at the old dip. And like I said, this is a very good tank, and you should get it. And that's it. Alright, but anyway, so yeah, that'll be it for this video, I guess. See you in a second!